Now, if you fail to do the normal extraction, you have to follow the complicated method of extraction. That is also called as a transalveolar method of extraction. So what is this complicated method of extraction? Extraction not involving the impactions, which cannot be removed by a simple application of the elevators of the forceps. That particular method called it as a transalveolar extraction. And we follow certain procedures, like we do need the reflection of the flap, we do the bone cutting, we do the sectioning of the tooth, and then with the help of the forceps and the elevators, we do the extraction, okay? There are few principles which are described by Robert B. Shira. What he said, we have to have the proper access, create an unimpeded path of removal, and use of the controlled force. That will help you, or that will exactly plan the method of the principle of the complicated absolutia. It is said that bone belongs to the patient and the tooth belongs to the surgeons, okay? Dear students, always keep it in mind. Instead of cutting more and more amount of the bone, it is always better to do the sectioning of the root or the tooth, because anyway the tooth is going to get sacrificed, okay? So instead of cutting the bone, because cutting of the bone will be more traumatic, more post-operative complication, more swelling, more edema, so it is always better to do the sectioning of the tooth, because anyway you are going to sacrifice that particular tooth, okay? And there are different methods of the cutting of the bone, the chisel method and the burr method. The burr is the routinely method used nowadays, which is very precise and the effective technique. But the only thing is there is always overheating of the bone. So we have to do a proper thorough irrigation with the help of the saline, okay? Post-extraction care, once you finish up the procedure, socket should be thoroughly examined, freshened, filled. If any debridement is needed, you do the debridement. Careful curettage of the periapical lesion if it is there. If any debris are there, calculus is there, it needs to be properly removed. Sharp bony edges should be properly smoothed out. And then the proper hemostasis is achieved with the help of the moistened gauze. Okay, so this is the post-operative care. Okay, obviously, not a single procedure is there without complication. Everybody knows about that. So we can come across different complications. And routinely complications, what we can come across are hemorrhage, nerve injury, oroenteral communications, oroenteral fistula, fracture of the bone. So these complications, you should be in a position to manage, okay? It is said in surgery that a surgeon who said that I never come across any complications means he has never done a surgery in his life, okay? So this is very, very important for us. Any surgical procedure, any extraction, whatever the procedure, minor surgery you are doing, you have to have come across the complication. The most important thing is you should be in a position to manage that particular complication. That is the key, okay? So this is very, very important for us, okay? And the delayed complications like infection, trismus, dry socket, pain, swelling, hematoma formation, and all these things you can come across, okay? My dear students, all these things are very, very nicely described in the books. So you can go through the books, and the post-operative patient's care is very, very important. The cause to be kept at least for half an hour to 45 minutes. Again, commonly asked question, why 45 minutes, why not 10 minutes, or why not 1.5 hours? You should defend it. Like it takes around 10 to 15 minutes for the formation of the clot, okay? The clotting time is, the bleeding and the clotting time, you know, about 7 to 10 minutes, okay? And once the clot is formed, the organization of that clot usually takes about 24 hours. But about 80% of the organization is followed in first 45 minutes. And that is the reason why the patient should be asked to keep the pack for 45 minutes, okay? Mouth should be avoided, mouthwash should be avoided. Application of the cold is very important. That will reduce the post-operative edema, post-operative swelling. That will also help in reducing the post-operative bleeding. The day after operation onwards, use the warm saline gargle, because it increases the blood supply by the heat of the warm saline which we are using to prevent the stiffness. We can give some exercises from 48 hours onwards. And diet, patient should be also properly instructed about the diet. And obviously, before I would like to conclude, the proper antibiotic cover is very, very important. Depending upon whatever your institutional protocols are there, you prescribe the antibiotics along with the painkillers and give the proper instructions to the patient. Okay, very, very important. Whatever the complication you have done, whatever the blunders you have done, if you proper have a dialogue with your patient, you can convince that patient, okay? And that is the most important thing. Your relation with the patient, your dialogues with the patient, your communication with the patient is most important. And if you think that the patient might come across ask any complication. Like you can tell them, like if you have a bleeding post-operatively, say after 24 hours, you immediately report to our OPD. All these things need to be properly. So patients' education is very, very important. That is what I mean to say.